the man of the hour, Julian Edelman, and also a Boston Bruins fan.
Huge Bruins fan. Grew up in the West Coast, moved out to Boston, and that's when they were getting hot. To see the support they have for the Bruins, it was contagious, and I started watching, became friends with some of the fellas, and now I've been a supporter for 10, 11 years.
How incredible was it to cheer on the Bruins and be in that stadium?
You know, the energy was awesome. You never know. You know, I was hopeful that, you know, it was going to be a comeback like some of the Super Bowls we've had in the past with the Patriots. So, you know, it was tough to leave Game 7 like that without the win on top. We're loyal New Englanders, so we're excited for next year already.
NHL fan Snoop Dogg. How did you become a hockey fan, Snoop?
Years ago, man, watching hockey, you know, listening to Chick Hearn, and it was a player named Marcel Dion that I fell in love with that played for the LA Kings back in the days.
I love your Hockey 101 videos. Being able to introduce different people to the sport, how cool has that been?
I mean, that's what it's about. I mean, hockey's a real hip sport. It's a international sport, and it deserves the attention that it deserves. So I just try to, you know, get with the commissioner and get with the players and try to make it bigger than what it's supposed to be.
If you had one person on that Snoop dream list that you can convert into a hockey fan, who would it be?
Probably President Obama. I would make him a hockey fan like he's a basketball fan.
How do you think Obama would do on the ice?
Pretty good. He cool. You know, ice cold.
What makes Boston sports and their fans so great?
They're one of a kind. I mean, they're always riding and dying for their teams. It's a professional college town, almost. You know, everyone loves their pro sports out here. And that's why it makes it the best place to play.
It's almost like we're all brothers in a sense. It's kind of like we all cheer for each other's team.
You guys are tough guys, but to see Chara play with the wire jaw, how hard is something like that?
We're not that tough compared to those jokers. You know, the things they play through and go through out there, those are tough dudes. I got a lot of respect for what they do on that ice.
We're in the offseason right now. If you were to give advice to NHL athletes on how they should enjoy the offseason, what's your advice?
Be young, wild, and free. Hang out in more hip-hop spots. Do a couple of rap videos.
Go out to Turk and Caicos.
You're a retired player. So yep. One of our great players, Roberto Luongo, just retired.
Yes.
What's your advice to him on how to enjoy his retirement the best way he can?
You know, I would say take a lot of time with the family. Do all the things you weren't able to do when you were working. And it's not really retirement. It's more like graduating. So you're moving on to another thing. You always got to continuously have something in your head that you're trying to do. So, yeah, that's it. And enjoy it.